heart conquered, the past broken, the splendor of the Father's glory is revealed. Let the whole world rejoice at the return of life and beauty.
You love.
Welcome to the Holy Sepulcher. Here we are on this day where we are going to be reflecting on Jesus Christ, Son of the living God, who was crucified, died, and was buried. So we're going to be speaking about his death today. And to do that, we have with us again a wonderful friar from Croatia, Father Sinisa. And he was with us in our last pilgrimage in October, and he's going to explain what we will see in just a few minutes, which is a procession here in the Holy Sepulchre. So maybe you could tell us a little bit about the history.
The first thing, we call that the daily procession. Why the daily procession? Because that procession, we repeat every day, every single day. Like that also, it's called even in Latin, Procession quotidiana, daily procession. Mm-hmm. That means that we repeat every day the same procession.
So this procession has probably been around for centuries, or how old is it?
The procession is for the centuries. For sure we have the testimonies of such way of the devotion even in the time of the Egeria, the first pilgrim.
Oh my goodness, that's the fourth century, right?
Fourth century. She testimony about one way of the processions inside of the Basilica, of the Church of the Holy Sepulchre. When we can speak first time about the procession, like it's more or less like it's today, what we know today, it's from 1430s.
Okay, from the 1430s.
Mm-hmm. From the 1430s, we have the sure the documents documented the procession that Franciscans are doing inside of the Basilica.
Oh, right. Interesting. So from 1430. That's wonderful. Well, I think Father Sinisa is going to take us around to some parts of the Holy Sepulchre as he tells us about what we will participate in. Okay, so take us a little bit around the Holy Sepulchre and show us where we'll be.
The procession has various stations. Mm-hmm. It's composed by the stations.
And they're called stations,
actually. They're called stations. Right. And we can say like that is something which after it's reflected in the way of the cross.
Right.
Like we know today, because here inside, we will not have traditional stations of the way of the cross, mm-hmm. but we will have the Jesus put it in the prison. He's waiting for the, after that, under the Calvary, we will have the division of the vestments.
Oh my goodness, all of that happens here.
Yes, we will commemorate that one.
Yes.
And after we will commemorate another thing around the cross, we will go down in the Chapel of St. Helen.
Really?
We will commemorate the founding of the cross.
Oh my gosh, that's incredible.
We commemorate founding of the cross and we commemorate St. Helen. After that, we go one more time up from the Chapel of St. Helen,
mm-hmm.
and we will commemorate the crown, the incarnations of the Jesus. We call that the stations of the improperium.
Of the improperium. What does that mean, Father?
It means that when they insult Jesus and they told him, that's also, you are the king, you are now...
My goodness, yes.
That's the station of the improperium.
Mm-hmm.
After that station, we will go up to the Calvary.
Ah, yes.
Because at the Calvary, we have three stations.
Mm-hmm.
And at the Calvary, we commemorate the kneeling on the cross.
Ah, of course. Us,
and the Jesus, the last moment and the cross. Mm-hmm. He's dying on the cross and his mother.
Yes.
After that, we go down to the anointing stone.
Oh, really?
At the anointing stone, we commemorate when they prepare the body with oils, linens, we put in the linens and the oils for the burial.
Yes. Do you actually carry linens with you?
No, we don't care, but we will incense all the stations.
Ah, okay. And what would be the meaning of incensing the stations?
Because incense is always the prayer also. And with incense, we venerate also something. With incense can be the venerating the liturgy or the holy objects,
mm-hmm.
like the relics or the statues or the person also. What living church. Or the priest who is representing the church,
that's Jesus.
And the living church. Mm-hmm. We are all the Christ in the reunited in the liturgy.
Yes.
And the Blessed Sacrament.
Mm-hmm. That's true. That's true.
Here in the stations, we will incense the stations, the places.
Uh-huh.
For example, around anointing stone, the priest will incense around the anointing stone.
Okay.
To venerate the place.
The place, the actual place. That's incredible.
The actual place. The same, he will do it at the Calvary. Or as well inside of the tomb.
So this is the, if I'm not mistaken, the entrance to the Chapel of St. Helen,
yes,
right?
Yes, that's the entrance to the Chapel of St. Helen, which commemorate also that great woman.
Mm-hmm.
That what we said, in this procession also, we cannot put out not only the mystery, yes, of our faith, but here inside, sometimes we don't notice that in the church, and sometimes today we are speaking, we don't have women in the church.
Mm-hmm.
Here inside, we will venerate three big moments that only reflecting the women's.
In their role, the women's role, their proper, yes.
Saint Helen,
Saint Helen,
like the mother of the emperor, the true cross and mm-hmm. all the things. The mother of Jesus, Blessed Virgin Mary,
that's
under
right.
the cross.
Of course, yes, of
and
course.
And after that, Mary Magdalene, mm-hmm. after the resurrection, and one more time, Jesus, he will meet his mother also after the resurrection.
Right, right. Like so three key women right here.
Yes. For example, right. We will not venerate the apostles.
Well, that's true. How interesting.
Okay, we will pray about that when they come at the tomb, but we will not have actual thing that we venerate only apostles. Or we'll venerate only evangelists or something.
Yes.
In that way, like we have the veneration of the women.
So for you, Father Sunisha, that is very significant, specifically because of so many people almost making telling the church that they don't respect the dignity of women, right? And here they always have. You always have.
For me, it's that thing that each of us have his own role
right.
inside of the church.
Everyone has a different role, an important role.
Mm-hmm. Because of that, and we cannot put aside that role of the church. We
right.
can say, it's Saint Helen.
That, yes, and really, if she wouldn't have been here again, this none of this would be here.
Yeah, it's for sure not in one of the stations. We're here. That's the column of the Improperium, what we said.
Oh, this is the column of the Improperium. And,
yes.
and what's significant about the column that it's actually
because
venerated here?
It's actually venerated here for sure. It's like what we have in our chapel, the column of the flagellation.
Right.
That's one of the columns probably from Praetorium, from
the Praetorium.
Palace. Yes. Which, or in the Byzantine period or after, they brought inside of the basilica.
And that they would have brought something that
yes.
was significant,
the,
of
yes.
course. Yes. Incredible.
And we have up, it's a little bit dark, the icon, uh-huh. the Jesus sitting
oh,
with
sure.
a scarlet cloak
uh-huh.
what they put on him.
Right, right. And it demonstrates what we remember right here.
Yes, so we venerate the place, we incense the place, and we pray in each station.
Mm-hmm.
Because each station inside of the daily procession is composed by one hymn.
A hymn?
One biblical verses
okay.
after that. And Oremus, the final prayer.
Mm-hmm.
And Our Father, Hail Mary, and Glory.
Oh, that's wonderful. It actually does sound like a way of the cross.
Yeah.
It sounds just like a way of the cross.
The daily procession, what was been also in the beginning, how developed the daily procession, it was been explanations of what happened inside. Because the fathers, they will gather the pilgrims, guide
yes.
them
uh-huh.
through the prayer, through that. In each station, sometimes they used to set one small homily or something, small explanation about the station. That's also how the procession developed during the history.
Oh, yes, that makes sense. That makes sense. And so they would have taken it then, the pilgrims, or asked a Franciscan to take that to their own parish back at home so they could also continue the devotion.
Yeah, like here also the most of the devotion, Franciscan devotion, goes around the cross. You visit all the churches and you pray that first part what we have from the way of the cross. We adore you.
And we praise you because by your holy cross
yes,
you have redeemed the world.
Yes.
It comes from here. My goodness, what a mark St. Francis left on the church. And
yeah.
we're so blessed to have all of you. Does it sound like the procession's going
it
to start soon?
Yeah.
So we should probably go, right, Father?
Yeah.
Okay, wonderful. Well, we will follow all of you and the procession. I want to thank you for the explanation.
You're welcome. You're
I
welcome.
Also just want to ask, all the prayers are in Latin, is that correct?
Yes, the procession's like all the official prayers, what we have here in the Basilica, it's in Latin.
How would you recommend that we live this procession as we go one by one to the altars?
I think that the point sometimes is that today we put too much to understand something immediately.
Okay.
And we put out mystery and we put out the meditation and we put because we need to understand everything.
Right.
We have the booklets, small booklets for the procession prepared already with the translations.
Okay, so you have the translations.
Yes, we have the translations in various languages of what will happen. But I always recommend for the people, don't read the translation during the procession. Okay. You can read a translation after to see what you... Because during the procession, even if you don't understand what's happening,
yes,
for sure you will pray.
And this is kind of like what faith does. It goes beyond understanding. It's,
yes,
an experience of a relationship, right?
Yes. If you don't do that...
And I think you've given a beautiful definition of what faith is. It really is entering into relationship through prayer, going beyond just your understanding and letting the Lord's grace work inside.
That's a point.
So I guess, where should we go to begin the procession?
Yes.
We'll follow
okay.
you, Father.
Okay.
The daily procession led by the Franciscans in the Holy Sepulchre owes its origins to the ancient liturgies of the Jerusalem Church, described by the famous pilgrim Egeria back in the end of the 300s. The Custos of the Holy Land back in 1623 made a definitive revision, and it was updated most recently, and the stations were fixed to 14 within the Holy Sepulchre. Each stopping point or station includes a moment for meditation, silence. There's prayers, antiphons, and a verse. Lord Jesus Christ, you gave your church an admirable sacrament as the abiding memorial of your passion. May we worship you in this sacred mystery, that its redeeming power may sanctify us always and teach us to live with hope for our future glory. Preserve, O noble pillar, the memory of the pains of Christ, by which the power of the devil was broken and our chains loosed. The earth cried out to the stars at the spilled blood of Abel. Cry out to the heavens, O pillar, at the spilled blood of Jesus. O Jesus, even stricken by these blows, you are continually glorified with the Father and the living Spirit, now and forever. Amen. I led you out of captivity in Egypt, vanquishing Pharaoh in the Red Sea, and you have responded by handing me over, bound, to the chief priests. Bound by love, he came to overcome us by grace, and did not shrink from the chains, the symbol of slavery. O sweet Jesus, our joy, whose sacred body was bound, forgive us our faults and grant us grace. Release your servants from the bonds of sin and bind them with the bonds of love. The soldiers, when they had crucified Jesus, took his vestments and divided them into four pieces, one for each of them. They divided my garments among them, for my robe they cast lots. Come, angels of peace, from your noble place in heaven, extend your wings and cover the body of Christ. He who fills the heavens with light, the earth with flowers, whom heavenly powers adore, is stripped of his garments by the soldiers. And so, we supplicants beg you, founder of the ages, that as you are despoiled of your garments, you clothe us in virtue. Faithful cross, alone in your glory among all other trees, no forest ever yielded its equal in flower, leaf, and fruit. Sweet wood that upon a sweet nail bears a sweet burden. You alone have been worthy to bear the ransom of the world, and as captain, anointed with the sacred blood poured out from the body of the Lamb to prepare a harbor for the shipwrecked world. Hail, you tree of grief and glory, here by Helen found of yore. By your ransom may our Maker please on us his grace to pour, grace forgiving, sin committed, grace to go and sin no more. O God, at this place you have continued to work the miracles of your passion by the enlightening discovery of your saving cross. Grant that this living wood may purchase for us the rewards of eternal life. Amen. Helen, the mother of Constantine, came to Jerusalem to find the cross of the Lord. The love of Jesus, which inspired Helen's faithful search for the cross of Christ, carried her along the difficult path to heaven. Here we beseech you, O Lord, the prayers of your family, which rejoices here and everywhere, at the fervent zeal of blessed Helen, who found here the wood of the Holy Cross, which she had pursued so diligently. I give you a royal scepter, and you have placed on my head a thorny crown. The faithful come and look upon the Son of David, not arrayed in splendid garments, but alas, stripped of them for the sport of the soldiers. Isaiah foretold he gives up his body to the torturers, his countenance to those who strike his cheeks and spit in his face. You have seen the Lord, O Moses, the red glow of the burning bush. We have seen him beaten down, spoiled by thorns and spittle. Remember Isaac, the sacrificial offering. Oh, if only a ram caught by its horns in the bushes could serve as a substitute for the victim. They took hold of Jesus and led him out. Bearing his own cross, he came to this place, which is called Calvary, Golgotha in Hebrew, where they crucified him. On this spot they have pierced my hands and my feet. I can count all of my bones. O blessed tree, from whose branches hung the ransom of the world, which liberated the victims of hell. Hail, O cross, our hope, here saturated with the blood of Christ. Flood your loyal people with grace and blot out the sins of the guilty. Let every pilgrim praise you, the Holy Trinity, the one source of salvation. By the victory of the cross, grant us our reward. Jesus Christ, Son of the living God, who at the sixth hour, when the whole world was shrouded in darkness, here on Calvary mounted the wood of the cross as the innocent victim for our redemption. Give us always that light which will bring us to eternal life. Amen. Look upon the bitter drink, the thorns, the nails, and the lance that pierced his tender body from which flowed blood and water. O earth, sea, stars, and world, which have been cleansed by this saving stream. It was about the sixth hour, and darkness overcame the whole world, even until the ninth hour, and the sun was eclipsed. The veil of the temple was torn from top to bottom. Calling out in a loud voice, Jesus said, Father, into your hands I commend my spirit. And saying this, he died on this very spot. When Jesus saw his mother standing at this very spot next to the cross and with her the disciple whom he loved, he said, Woman, behold your son. Then he said to the disciple, Behold your mother. At the cross, her station keeping, stood the mournful mother weeping, close to Jesus to the last. Bruised, derided, cursed, defiled, she beheld her tender child, all with scourges rent. Joseph and Nicodemus took the body of Christ and wrapped it here with spices and linen cloths, as is the burial custom of the Jews. I see the sacred body stripped of garments, disfigured by wounds. Christ, the Lord of heaven, is covered with blood. I see his hands carefully folded as he is laid upon this stony bed. Lord Jesus, you granted to the devotion of your faithful friends the privilege of anointing your sacred body with oils in this place. Grant that our hearts, anointed by your grace, may be preserved in health, free from all infection of sin. Amen. Dawn is purpling o'er the sky. The heavens resound with praise. The triumphant world exults with joy, while hateful hell gnashes its teeth. He, stronger than any king, entered the world of the dead and leads the assembly of the patriarchs out to the joy of life. The Lord has risen from this sepulcher, he who for us hung upon the cross. On this spot, the angel said to the women, "Do not tremble. You seek Jesus of Nazareth, who is crucified. He is risen. He is not here. Behold the place where they have laid him." Early in the morning on the first Sunday, the risen Jesus appeared here to Mary Magdalene, from whom he had cast out seven demons. "Mary, do not touch me, for I have not yet ascended to my Father." Christ wanted to show his triumphant glory to everyone, but to bring the first joyful news to those who loved him more than the rest. So it was that Mary Magdalene received the news in the first glow of dawn, as filled with the love of Christ, she hastened to the tomb. Almighty and ever-living God, your only begotten Son, Jesus Christ, in this place, made Mary Magdalene the herald of Easter joy, the apostle to the apostles. Grant that following her example and helped by her prayers, we may in this life proclaim the living Christ and come to see him reigning with you in glory. Amen. Jesus Christ, crucified for the wrongdoings of sinners, this you have seen and wept over, O Mary. With death conquered, the past broken, the splendor of the Father's glory is revealed. Let the whole world rejoice at the return of life and beauty. Queen of heaven, rejoice, alleluia, for the Son you bore, alleluia, as risen as he said, alleluia. Lord God, as you brought joy to the world through the resurrection of our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, grant that through his Virgin Mother we may come to the joys of eternal life. Amen. Brothers and sisters, as we go forth, we should remind ourselves of the reasons we have come to these holy places, made this holy pilgrimage, to the tomb of our Lord Jesus Christ. These holy places that we have visited are monuments to the devotion of the people of God. They have gone here in great numbers to be strengthened in the Christian way of life and become more determined to devote themselves to the works of charity. We must also try to bring something to all those around us, our example of faith, hope, and love. In this way, they and we will be enriched by the help we give one another. May the Lord grant that our life's journey, our pilgrimage, will be one that always relies on Him, trusting in Him fully, so that one day we will be with Him happily forever. Amen. Now that we've finished this procession here in the Holy Sepulchre, I wanted to thank Father Salvador. He is the superior here and also the one in charge of the Holy Sepulchre. And I think he has a message for the pilgrims, but most especially, I can't thank you all enough for allowing me to come in your place to walk these 14 altars, if I'm not mistaken. The beginning of the Way of the Cross that happened right here, centuries and centuries ago in the Holy Sepulchre, and you were able to live it. So, Father Chava, thank you again.
Welcome.
And if you could give a message to our pilgrims, I'd be happy to translate, or I know that you do speak some English, so...
Spanish is better.
Okay.
Un abrazo a todos nuestros peregrinos virtuales.
It's a very warm hello to each one of the pilgrims that are watching.
Con el deseo de poder encontrarnos en un futuro próximo.
And he's hoping that he can also meet you in some future date, very soon.
Y mientras esto sea posible, estén tranquilos que sus oraciones están presentes en nuestros corazones, en la de los frailes franciscanos, en la de los diferentes institutos religiosos que vivimos en Tierra Santa.
And just know that even when you can't come, all the Franciscan friars and the different religious orders here in the Holy Land have you and your intentions very much in their prayers.
Oramos mutuamente y los esperamos.
Let's pray for each other a lot, and we can't wait to see you here.